So in this chapter, we have discussed the different types of systems. So which helps our body to perform our regular activities. So what are the different types of systems we have discussed? That is the nervous system and muscular system and skeletal system and circulatory system and digestive system, excretory system, reproductive system. So these are the different types of systems present in our human body. So which helps our human body to perform our regular activities. And all these systems will coordinate each other and they will help our body. So also we have discussed in this chapter about sense organs. So how the sense organs receives information and how the brain sends information to the sense organs and what are the preventive measures. So what are the measures to be taken to care about our sense organs. So this is the chapter and now we will practice some exercises in the activity part on the topics up to now what we have discussed in the chapter. So let us recall. So the topics we have discussed in this chapter by practicing some exercises in the activity part. So let us go to the activity part. So in this activity part there will be some exercises, that is writing answers for the questions and some true or false sentences and writing and filling the blanks and also matchings like etc. So children, see the first section in the activity part, that is section A, answer these questions. So in this section they will give some questions, we have to write the answers for those questions. So children, see the first question, what are the functions of the skeletal system? So what are the functions of the skeletal system? So what is the answer, children? So the answer for this question is the skeletal system gives shape and support to our body and it also protects our vital organs like brain, heart, lungs, etc. So children, so what are the functions of skeletal system? So the skeletal system consists of different types of bones having different sizes and having different shapes and all these bones join together in various forms and form a frame-like structure. And this frame work is called skeletal system and this skeletal system gives shape to our body. So how we will get shape? Because of the skeletal system. And it also gives support. It also gives support to our body. If there is no skeletal system in our body, we cannot stand upright and we cannot sit, we cannot walk, we cannot run. So that's why the skeletal system gives support to our body. And also it protects some vital organs, that is it protects some internal organs like heart, lungs, brain, etc. So these are the functions of the skeletal system. So children, so what is the second question? So read the second question. What is the nervous system? So what is nervous system? So read the answer. Children, the system which controls all the activities of the body is called the nervous system. It is made of brain, spinal cord and nerves. That is nerves. So children, what is nervous system? So nervous system, so it controls all the activities of our human body. So it controls all the activities which we perform daily, like it will controls our speaking, and it will controls our walking, running and jumping, speaking, writing and also remembering. So all these types will be controlled under the control of nervous system. So that's why the system can also be called as a communication system in our body. So the main parts of in this body are brain, spinal cord and nerves. So especially the brain receives the information from our sense organs. That is eyes, ears, nose and tongue and skin. It receives the information from our sense organs and again resends the information to the sense organs. Then only we are getting the information about our surroundings. And the spinal cord also will receive the information from various parts of our body and it sends that information to the brain. So, and also these nerves are helpful in carrying the information from the body parts to brain and again from brain to body parts. So, these nerves will act as carriers. So, children, so this is about the nervous system. So, different types of activities. That means all activities will be under this control. So, children, see the third question here. So, what is the third question? Name the various parts of the digestive system. So, what are the various parts of the digestive system? So, children, see the answer here. The mouth, the food pipe, the stomach, the intestines, and the anus are the various parts of the digestive system. So, digestive system, it is one of the important system in our body. So, it converts our food items into simpler form. We will eat different types of food items every day, which contains oils and fats, so etc. And all these food items should be converted into simpler form. Then only our body can absorb the nutrients from that food. So, this conversion of food into simpler form is called digestion. So, this digestive system makes the digestion of the food. And what are the various parts of the digestive system? That is the mouth. First, we will chew the food in our mouth. And from the mouth, it will go to stomach through the food pipe. So, this is called the food pipe. So, from the mouth, it will reach to our stomach through the food pipe. And from the stomach, so in the stomach, the food will be mixed with different types of digestive enzymes and it will be converted into simpler form. And from the stomach, the simpler form of the food will be sent to intestines. There will be two types of intestine, small intestine and large intestine. So the first, the food will be sent to small intestine and there the small intestine absorbs the nutrients from the food. And the waste food will be sent to the larger intestine and from there the waste food will be come out from the anus. So, these are the various parts and the various functions of these parts of the digestive system. So, children, read the fourth question here. Name the organs of the body which help in removing waste. So, children, so there will be different types of wastes produced in our body. So, during digestion and during respiration, so some of the wastes will be produced in our body and those waste materials should be sent out from our body. Otherwise, if the waste materials are not sent out and if they are accumulated in our body, they will cause us a lot of diseases. So, there will be some special systems in our body to send out these waste materials from our body. So, let us see. So, name the organs. So, which organs will help to send out the removing wastes? That is, the first organ is kidney. So, helps in removing the wastes from the blood. And next, lungs. Helps in removing carbon dioxide. And the third one is skin. Helps in removing wastes as you say. So, generally children, so these are the three excretory organs. So, these three organs are called excretory organs. These organs will send out the waste material from our body. So, kidneys, so daily they will clean our blood, they will purify our blood. The kidneys will act as purifiers. They act as filters of our blood and they will filter the impurities from the blood and they will be sent out in the form of urine. And also lungs. So, lungs help in removing carbon dioxide. Whereas, the lungs takes oxygen and oxygen will be sent to the blood and the blood will again carry the carbon dioxide to the lungs. The carbon dioxide will be sent out through our nose so that the lungs helps in removing carbon dioxide. So, lungs takes oxygen and removes carbon dioxide. And also skin. So, excess of the minerals, that is excess of the salts and excess water will be removed out, that is will be sent out in the form of sweat. So, So these three organs are helpful in removing the wastage. So children, note down these questions in your notebook. Children, see the fifth question. How does the reproductive system help the living beings? How the reproductive system help the living beings? Children, read the answer. The reproductive system helps the living beings in producing the young ones of their kind. So children, every living organism can be able to produce. That means all the living organisms gave birth to the younger ones. That is, all the living organisms will produce young babies which are looking similar to them. So this process of giving birth to the younger ones which are looking similar to them is called reproduction. So because of this reproduction, all the animals are able to continue to live on this earth. So if there is no reproduction and if there is no reproductive system, the living organisms cannot able to produce their younger ones and their race will become extinct and they cannot survive no more time on this earth. So because of their younger ones, they will grow into an adult one, again they will reproduce their younger ones, and the younger ones again grow into adult one, those adult ones again reproduce their younger ones. So this process continues and they will multiply their numbers on the earth, and it is possible to continue their race on this earth. So that's why this reproductive system helps the living being to producing the young ones of their kind. This reproductive system helps them to continue to live on this earth without becoming extinct. So children, so note down this question also in your notebook.